Okay, yeah. Hi, I'm James Burton. I teach Iyengar yoga over at the Boise Yoga Center. And today I'm just going to give a short demonstration on Iyengar yoga. In particular, well, this demonstration is going to be focusing on padmasana, which is, well, padmasana is probably the best known of all the yoga poses, certainly the most iconic of all the yoga poses. Padmasana, padma means lotus, asana is loosely translated as pose or posture, so this is the lotus pose that we're talking about. It's probably the best known because the Buddha is almost always depicted sitting in this pose, as is many of the other Indian sages and deities. Probably a more accurate translation of the word asana is actually seat, and I think it came from the seat that the yogi sat on while he was meditating or practicing pranayama, breathing. So in a lot of ways, padmasana is the original asana. So my demonstration is going to be based on padmasana, and there are many, many variations of padmasana. I'm only going to show some, or we'd be here all day. And also to help keep it concise, I'm just going to show one side of each pose rather than change sides for each one. So I'm just going to collect myself here and get started right now. I'll call out the names of the asanas. I only use the Sanskrit. I don't even know what the English names are for most of them. So I'm just going to use the Sanskrit pronunciation and just holler it out since I won't have a microphone. Oh, got a situation back there. Yeah. So anyway, before the dome blows away, I'm going to get started here. I'll just yell the poses out. Yeah. So I'm just going to do a few little things just to get my hips warmed up a bit first. Starting in padasana. Padasana, tree pose. Adho Mukha Padmasana, first variation. Variation is the same as clasping the foot behind the back. Sukta Padangusthasana, third variation. Then a reclining Adha Padmasana, or half Padmasana. Supta Baddha Padmasana. Adha Baddha Padma Paschimottanasana. Padmasana. Padmasana going into Bharatvajasana too. Asana, the easy version. What's the asana, the harder version? And this next pose is probably the shortest held asana out of all the asanas. If you're going to hold it for more than one breath, you're doing pretty well. It's called Gorakasana. And this next pose is quite interesting because it's the only asanas where a sound is uttered. The pose is called Simhasana. Simha means lion, so it's the lion pose. Because the shape resembles a lion and then the sound resembles a lion as well. First to Shirshasana. Mm-hmm.
padmasana. Padmasana. Urva padmasana. Urva means upward facing. Urva padmasana. Pashva urva padmasana in shirshasana. The next pose is called Pindasana. Pinda means fetus. The pose represents or resembles a fetus in the womb. First to Halasana. Urva Padmasana in Sarvangasana. Pindasana in Sarvangasana, that's the fetus again. Pashva Pindasana. Uttana Padma Mayurasana. Thank you.